Please enjoy hundreds of my video lectures on telecom and wireless. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Please also like my videos. Please share my channel with your friends and colleagues. Thank you.
In this slide, we will discuss soft handoffs. Look at the figures on your screen. What is soft handoff? If a mobile terminal moves away from a base station and continues to increase its transmit power to maintain contact with the base station, at the edge of the cell, the mobile needs to perform a handoff to some other adjacent cell. This is also due to near-far problem. Now what does the mobile do? Mobile starts communications with the target base station without interrupting communications with the current serving base station. That the mobile is in contact with the current base station as well as the futuristic base station. The mobile will communicate with multiple base stations simultaneously for a short while before making a decision on the final candidate. Mobile station compares frames from each of these neighboring cells and uses the best one. Up to 3 cells can be involved simultaneously while mobile is making this decision. Let's now look at the new animation. Soft handoff is a make before break handoff. Soft handoffs are achieved with the base stations which are supporting the same frequency, F1 in the old cell and F1 in the new cell, and connected to the same BSC. This is possible because of the rake receiver configuration that is unique to CDMA, which is not there in GSM. Okay, let us look at what we mean by pilot search. Mobile station continuously keeps searching for new cells as it moves across the network. Mobile maintains 4 groups of pilots. They have 4 sets: active set, neighbor set, candidate set, and remaining set. Okay, now what are the advantages of soft handoff? Soft handoff is both necessary and a positive feature of CDMA. We have explained this also in some detail earlier on. Mobile transmit power is reduced. It is necessary due to the power control. Before the power of the mobile exceeds a certain power level, it is handed over to a better base station and the power drops. Thereby, overall, the power levels within the network are kept at minimum levels. Due to power control, the mobile should always be communicating with the base station which has got the strongest pilot. That means overall system efficiency improves. Soft handoff improves the system performance by improving the coverage through what is known as macro diversity. Do you remember discussing this earlier on? We discussed this while we were talking about rake receivers. If you don't remember, please go back and refer. Soft handoff also improves the system performance by reducing call dropping probability and also reducing the required EB by I0 by providing macro diversity. It will be interesting to know that soft handoff improves overall system capacity both in the downlink and also in the uplink. In the downlink, what happens? The power levels have reduced, therefore interference levels also have reduced, and due to this reduced interference on the downlink, the system capacity automatically improves. Lesser noise means more subscribers can participate in conversations. On the uplink, the reduced interference to other cells, that is this cell, because of its overall power level being low, provides lesser interference to other cells, and therefore uplink capacity also increases. Okay, is it advantages all the way? No, there are quite a few disadvantages also for soft handoff. What are they? Soft handoff reduces system capacity as the mobile will be trying up to 2 traffic channels. Earlier we said it improves system capacity, but what we did not tell was that each mobile will be engaging 2 or 3 base stations simultaneously to get all its improvement. That mobile will be tying up 2 traffic channels or 3 traffic channels at a time while doing this soft handoff. Okay, the next one is increased network resource usage due to communication between several base stations. That means the network resources also are being unnecessarily used by these duplications. And increased Walsh code usage on the downlink. That means another resource which is Walsh code is also being used up because one mobile is in conversation with multiple base stations. These are obvious disadvantages of soft handoff. Let us look at how CDMA soft handoff occurs, both in the downlink and in the uplink. How does soft handoff happen? The mobile initiates soft handoff requests. The mobile continuously searches for pilots at the same carrier frequency and measures the strength of all the pilots it receives. When the mobile station detects a new pilot of significant increased strength, say 3 dB more than the current one, it sends a message to the serving base station. The cellular network, that is a BSC, decides which neighbor base stations can be involved in a handoff and selects an idle Walsh function which represents a traffic channel. The selected BTS is given the mobile's long code mask. The serving base station is directed to send the mobile a message to initiate the soft handoff. Now let's look at the new figure that's appearing on your screen. What happens in forward link during soft handoff? In the forward link, the mobile receives information from both the forward links of the serving base station and the selected or the futuristic base station. The mobile uses the rake receiver to coherently combine the signals using the pilot sequence of both the base stations. This combination of multiple forward link signals improves overall link performance, especially during the handoff. Let us look at the new figure that is appearing on your screen, which talks about a reverse link soft handoff. What happens in the reverse link? In the reverse link, both the base stations are receiving the transmitted speech frames from the same mobile. Two base stations receiving signals from one mobile. The highest quality traffic frame received from among these two base stations is selected on a frame by frame basis. The two base stations communicate with each other and determine at this point of time which frame shall I send. Shall I send mine or shall I send yours? Now there is another aspect, power control. Who controls the mobile? One base station or both base stations? Let's look at that. The closed loop power control of the mobile user is also handled jointly between these two serving base stations. The base stations send identical traffic frames with the exception of the power control bits. If all the serving base stations request the mobile to increase its power, the mobile will increase its output power by 1 dB nominally. However, if any one of the serving stations requests a decrease in power, the mobile will drop its output by 1 dB. A bit chaotic, but that's the way it is. If there are two master base stations, the mobile will very often get confused when it receives conflicting power control commands from multiple base stations. But that's the way it is. Let us look at softer handoff in this slide. What is softer handoff? We have seen this briefly earlier on. This is also like soft handoff, but the handoff is within the same base station, typically between different sectors. Let's look at this new figure. The mobile will be served by two sectors of the same cell. Signals received by different sectors can be combined by the rake receiver in the base station. Communication is maintained across both sectors until the mobile transition has been completed. Handoff is between sectors of the same cell. Please remember this. Communications are maintained across both sectors until the mobile station transition is totally complete. This may happen frequently. Mobile switching center, that is MSC, is definitely aware of this, but it does not participate nor it interferes. All activities are managed by the cell site itself. Signals received at both sectors can be combined for improvement in the quality. Okay, fine. Now, how is it different from soft handoff? Softer handoff differs from soft handoff primarily on the uplink. In the downlink, virtually there is no change. Let us look at the new figure which describes the uplink softer handoff. In soft handoff, each base station reports frame estimates to the mobile switching center, that is MSC, and MSC will choose one of the two frames. In softer handoff, the base station can coherently combine the multipaths from different sectors using a rake receiver. Once the base station has coherently combined these two signals, there is only one signal at its output and that is sent to the BSC from the base station. BSC does the selection of the frames in the softer handoff. MSC does not select anything, only BSC does. And only one frame estimate is then sent to the MSC for power control purposes. Okay, what's the advantage? Softer handoff enables greater efficiency in the use of hardware since only one channel element is used to support such a handoff. Two channel elements are not involved, unlike in soft handoff, and therefore resource utilization is far better in software handoff than in soft handoff. Let us now look at CDMA's hard handoff in this line. Let's look at the figures. What is hard handoff? A hard handoff occurs when a CDMA call is transferred from one base station to another base station, transmitting on a different carrier frequency. Hard handoff is always on different carrier frequencies. Please remember this. The mobile unit will seek to perform a soft handoff. If the cellular network cannot perform a soft handoff, then a hard handoff is necessary. It's a break before make approach. We have seen this already a little bit. The mobile drops the original traffic channel before establishing a new link. The voice is muted momentarily during this process. Okay, what are the two systemic or generic hard handoffs? Let's look at the new figure. The first one is CDMA to a different system, that is analog mobile phone service AMPS system, CDMA to AMPS hard handoff. In this case, the mobile will be traveling within the AMPS system and there is no CDMA service. The other type can be inter-system. In this case, the mobile is traveling into another system that has no CDMA service, maybe into GSM. Now let's look at a different type of hard handoff. Let's look at the new figure. This is CDMA to CDMA hard handoff. There are again two types, intra-system and inter-system. In the intra-system, between two base stations on the same system, that is within the same MSC, this hard handoff occurs between cells operating on different frequencies. This is one type of system which is intra-system. In the inter-system, hard handoff occurs between base stations on different systems. This is two different MSCs. Occurs between cells operating on different frequencies. The essential difference is, in intra-system, everything happens within the same MSC, and in the inter-system, it happens between two different MSCs. Okay, why hard handoff takes place at all? What are the typical conditions? Hard handoff occurs when the frequencies of two cells are different. We know this. Hard handoff occurs when cells are not synchronized. Hard handoff occurs when cells are controlled by different BSCs. These are the three conditions in which hard handoff becomes inevitable. How many types of hard handoffs are there? There are four of them. We will not discuss any of these things in detail since they are beyond the scope of this current course. And you can look at our advanced course for more details. What are the four types of hard handoff? RTD, round trip delay, pilot beacon, EHHO, 3G, 2G trigger. As I said, we will not discuss any of these things in detail in this lecture.
Hi guys, hope you have enjoyed this video. Before you leave this, please ensure that you are subscribing to this. Also, please do like these videos and share it amongst your friends and colleagues. There are plenty of other videos and I hope you will be able to find time to browse through all these things. Thank you.